In this problem, we're going to look at diffusion of hydrogen through palladium. This is one method that can be used to purify hydrogen from a mixture. And what we want to determine is how hot do we have to heat this palladium membrane that is 30 microns thick in order to obtain a hydrogen flux of 10 to the minus 5 grams per square centimeter per second. We're given the hydrogen concentrations inside the membrane at the two sides. In other words, this is hydrogen atoms that are dissolved within the palladium at each side of the membrane. And we're given the diffusivity, which is a function of temperature, and we want to solve for the temperature. And so let's look at a diagram of this process first. So this is our membrane, the palladium, 30 microns thick, which is 3 times 10 to the minus 3 centimeters to be consistent units. We have a mixture on the left side that's at higher pressure than right side, which is essentially pure hydrogen. And we're given these two concentrations. Now keep in mind, these concentrations are within the palladium right at the surfaces, and they're obtained by having a certain concentration of hydrogen, for example, on the feed side, and having some equilibrium relationship between the hydrogen in the mixture and how much is absorbed within the palladium. So what we want to calculate now, we know the value of the flux, and the flux is related from Fick's law to the diffusivity and the change in the concentration of hydrogen with respect to distance. So I'll call this x equals 0, x equals L. Because the flux is constant, we can write this as a difference between the concentration of two sides and the thickness of the membrane. So we know this flux. We can calculate this concentration gradient and therefore solve for D. Once we have D, we can go back to this equation because this here is the value of D, and we can solve for temperature. So we can calculate delta C over delta X. So now that I have delta C over delta X, I can write the flux. We're given the flux. I'm substituting in the values so I can solve for my diffusivity. So calculate the diffusivity, and the units end up being centimeter squared per second. Then we're given that this is equal to, so I can rearrange and take logs to solve for the temperature, where I'm going to use R is equal to 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. So this is doing the division, and now I'll take the log of both sides, and then I can solve for the temperature, and the temperature is 711 Kelvin. Significant figures at best is this. Maybe 440 centigrade. This is the temperature that we need to have the flux of 10 to the minus 5 grams per square centimeter per second.